Hey everyone, it's time for Saturday Stories with Miss Sharon. Today's story is coming from this Bible, the Laugh and Learn Bible for Kids. This is one we use a lot in Sunday school, and I think you'll really enjoy today's story called John Baptizes Jesus. John is a popular name, isn't it? There are lots of people named John. There are two very famous Johns in the Bible. The first famous John is John the disciple. He was one of Jesus' closest friends. He also wrote 5 different books in the Bible. The other famous John is John the Baptist. John the Baptist was a relative of Jesus. He was 6 months older than him. We call John the Baptist because he baptized people. That means he dunked people in the water, usually a river or a stream, and as a sign that they wanted to have their sins washed away. Even today, being baptized shows that a person wants to live for God. If you met John the Baptist, you'd probably think to yourself, "This guy is a little strange." John the Baptist wasn't like most Israelites. He didn't dress like they did. Instead of clothes made from soft wool or cotton, he chose to wear clothes from itchy camel hair or other animal skins. Instead of eating the food like most folks ate, John ate only honey and bugs. Yuck. And John didn't live in one of the towns of Israel like everyone else. John lived out in the wilderness all by himself. Yep, John the Baptist was a little unusual. John spent his days walking around in his itchy camel clothes, preaching about the kingdom of God and the Messiah. "Stop doing bad things," he'd yell. "The day of God is coming." Soon, people from towns and villages started coming out to see this bug-eating guy in itchy camel clothes who said he had a message from God. "Is this a new prophet?" they wondered. Israel hadn't had a new prophet in 400 years. "Maybe he is the Messiah," someone said. But John shook his head. "I'm not the Messiah. He is coming. Someone so great that I don't even deserve to touch his shoes." People were amazed. This bug-eating, camel-clothed guy seemed like he was really close to God. Who could be coming that was even closer? By now, Jesus was around 30 years old, but the people didn't know who he was. One day, Jesus came to John and said, "Baptize me." John was confused. He knew who Jesus was. He knew that Jesus had never done anything wrong. It seemed to him that Jesus should baptize John, not the other way around. But Jesus said, "No, it is right that you should baptize me." So John baptized Jesus in the river, and when Jesus came up out of the water, something amazing happened. First, something that looked like a dove came down from the sky and landed on Jesus. It was the Spirit of God. Then a voice came out of the air and said, "This is my son, whom I love very much. I am very happy with him." It was the voice of God. People couldn't believe what they had seen and heard. The Spirit of God came to rest on this fellow they'd never heard of, this Jesus, and God himself had spoken out loud about him. Who was Jesus? Was he the Messiah they had been waiting on for so long? Was this finally God's blessing for the world? No one knew for sure, but they went home that day very excited. So let's think about this story a little bit, and here's a couple of questions for you to talk over with your family today. What made John the Baptist stand out from the crowd? And why do you think Jesus asked John to baptize him? Have you been baptized? In our church, sometimes you see baptisms of babies when there's just a little bit of sprinkled water done by Pastor Mark right on top of the baby's head. And sometimes you see that when kids are older, like after they've been through confirmation. And sometimes adults get baptized too. I'm looking forward to the day you decide to become baptized. I'll see you next Saturday.